today's video is going to be talking about the dermatology procedure of a simple excision. Now, fortunately, these procedures are done in the vast majority of times while you're awake. So it's just local anesthesia. It's just a little bit more than the biopsy was. So that little poke and a burn, you're going to feel a little bit more of that, but you're awake for the whole time. So what's going to happen is we're going to bring you back into the room. We're going to find the area, draw on it, show you a picture of what we're doing. It'll be locally numbed and cleaned. And then we're just going to simply cut around the lesion. All right, so we've numbed around this area, and you can see the area of the biopsy here. For this lesion, we're giving 3 millimeter margins. And so for 3 millimeter margins to go all the way around, we're doing something like this. But you can't close a circle. You have to elongate it. And so it's usually 3 to 5 times the width of the lesion is how long it will be. So I'm going to be cutting into the area. Patient, all the patient needs to do is let us know if they're feeling any pain. And it also helps if the patient keeps breathing. And then for each excision, we cut down to the appropriate level of depth. For this one, I don't need a lot of depth. So I'm just going into the fat layer here, cutting it out. And then it goes off to the lab to see if we've gotten around it. And that usually takes about 2 weeks. We'll prepare the wound after we've cut around the lesion, and then we'll put deep stitches and superficial stitches. Now I'm taking the sutures, and we're going to place these underneath the skin. The deep stitches slowly dissolve over about a year. And those deep stitches look like a little string. They're very thin. So please do not think that 1 week after your surgery, you're good to do whatever you need to do. That little string is holding it together for the first 6 weeks. So the more gentle you can be with it, the better. Now, sometimes those stitches spit out later. Instead of being absorbed by your body in about a year, sometimes they spit out. If that happens, you're going to feel a little sandpaper-like quality to it and feel a little string there. What you can do with that is gently grab a pair of tweezers and gently pull. If it's ready to come out, it'll naturally come out. If it's not, I do not want you tugging on it. And then we're also going to put superficial stitches on the top. Those will be taken out usually within 5 to 21 days. Now, it's important to not let dirty water run down over this in the shower for 24 to 48 hours after the surgery. And the reason is this will not be watertight. So if you let dirty water wash over something that's not watertight, that can cause an infection. And that rule holds for most areas of the body except for lower legs. I prefer 4 days of no dirty water running over the area after the surgery for lower legs. We will then dress the wound and send you home with the post-operative instructions. Now, please look at our post-op video that you can find the link in the description below so that you know how to take care of your wound afterwards. Please also ask your dermatologist what the follow-up care is for this. So we're going to have you back in a couple of months to see how the wound is healing. But we're probably also going to have you back in a couple of months to look your body over again, to make sure nothing is new, changing, or concerning to us. A lot of times when we do these initial biopsies or procedures, we're taking 1 or 2 or 3 biopsies to see if this is just how your body grows something and it's normal, or if what our eyes detect as something that is concerning actually is concerning. We're kind of using it as a litmus test, because if we take 2 or 3 biopsies and everything's normal, we're going to look at your skin a little differently than if we took 2 or 3 biopsies and everything is abnormal. That's going to raise our index of suspicion for other lesions on your body. So please have a conversation with your dermatologist about what your follow-up care is. And as always, we thank you for allowing us to help you become comfortable in your skin. After watching this video, please also watch the pre-operation video, the post-operation video, and the potential complications video so that you can achieve the best outcomes possible.